The talk shall now be about increment and decrement operators in C. By the word increment, you mean trying to increase something by a value. Decrement means trying to decrease something by a value. So what the decrement and increment operators do is, suppose I have a variable int I is assigned the value 0. So if I do I plus plus, this is called as the postfix increment because the plus plus comes after I. If I do plus plus I, this is called as the prefix increment because the plus plus comes before I. Similarly, if I do minus minus I, this is called as the prefix decrement because I am decreasing the value of I. Similarly, I minus minus is called as the postfix decrement because the minus minus comes after I. In all these cases, the value of I is going to increase or decrease by 1. The easiest way to understand the working of the increment and the decrement operators is by taking a look at this following code snippet. So what I have done here is, I have declared an integer variable equal to I. I have declared a variable again j, which happens to be of the type integer with the initial value 2. In order to understand the working of this particular piece of code, what I will do is, I will draw a table depicting the values of I and j. So initially I is 0, j is 2. So in the first step, what is happening is, I is being assigned the value of j plus plus. Since this is a post increment, that is the increment is happening afterwards, the original value of j is going to be assigned to I. After this semicolon, the value of j is going to be increased by 1 and j ends up becoming 3. So when you print the value of I after this semicolon, you will see that the value of I is 2. If you try to print the value of j, it's going to be 3. But the old value of j is assigned because it's a postfix increment. Now next step, I is equal to plus plus j. This is an example of a prefix increment. So what is going to happen is, first the value of j is going to be increased by 1. And then this new value of j is then going to be copied to I. So in this case, I also ends up becoming 4. So if you print the value of I is going to be 4 and j is also going to be 4. Then in the third step, I am saying j is assigned minus minus I. Since I am reducing the value of I first and then giving it to j, so I will first end up becoming 3 and this value of 3 will get copied to j. So j is 3. I is 3. That's why the value of j is shown as 3 here. Then the following step, I'm saying j is assigned I minus minus. This is an example of a postfix decrement. Because it's a postfix decrement, the original value of I, which happens to be 3, is given to j. After the semicolon, the value of I is going to get reduced by 1. It is going to be equal to 2. So this should give you a fair idea of how the increment and decrement operators work. It's quite simple. Just need to be careful with this plus plus and minus minus, whether it's a pre-increment or a post-increment when you're trying to assign it to any memory location on the left-hand side. Now, let's say you have an integer variable called I and I've defined another variable called as j equal to 1. When I say I is assigned j plus 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 j, if you try to run this, different compilers are going to produce different outputs because this is something in C which is not defined, or it's a behavior left to the compiler to determine what is going to be the output. I'll tell you why it is like that. If the value of a same memory location, in this case it's a variable j, is changed more than once in an expression, in the single expression, then the result is not defined by C. The result is dependent on compiler to compiler. Different compilers will produce different answers for this. So I may take some other value in one compiler, it may take another value in another compiler. Let me give you one more example to understand it. Suppose I say I is equal to plus plus y and I say y minus minus. All right, here again, assume y was 10. You cannot be sure what is going to be the value of I because compiler to compiler are going to process this in different ways. The reason being, you have tried to change the value of y in the same expression twice. Therefore, the behavior is undefined or compiler dependent. Because it's compiler dependent, the value of I is going to be different from compiler to compiler. One more example. Suppose I say j is equal to minus minus I upon plus plus I. This is another classic example where the result is not going to be defined. But suppose I say j is assigned the value x plus plus minus plus plus I. This is not a problem because x and I are two different memory location. But in place of x, if I replace this with I, then you're going to have the same problem what you had here. So this should hopefully give you a decent understanding of the increment and decrement operator and how you go about using it in your code judiciously.